When we think about investing, one of the areas is income. And many individuals build their portfolios around the level of income that they need to live on, especially as people approach retirement. The unfortunate part is that today, with interest rates at 60-year lows, it's extremely difficult to get the income that we need from the traditional types of fixed income investments. Back in the old days, people would say, well, as we approach retirement, we have more in bonds and CDs because that provides us with a steady flow of income. Well, today, with interest rates as low as they are, you can't survive on income that's in the 1.5% to 2% range. Consequently, you have to look at alternatives. As I talk to portfolio managers, they continue to tell me that they look at dividend-paying stocks as an alternative to owning fixed income bonds. Why? Because the dividends from corporations tend to grow through time as businesses raise their prices and continue to have levels of profit that are normal. Consequently, portfolio managers feel that investing in dividend-paying stocks not only provides an income stream that is higher than today's fixed income bonds, but also provides an increasing income stream as time goes by. This is really important because when we think of income, it's just not the income we're looking at. It's the inflation and the taxes that impact that level of income through time. Consequently, you can't just look at income in a vacuum. You have to take a look at the impact that inflation does have on it, as well as what portion of it is paid out in income taxes. As a result of that, not only should you look at dividend-paying stocks through mutual funds, as we do, but also other alternatives, things like real estate investment trusts. In some cases, even some of the variable annuity products that exist out there tend to provide streams of income that are higher than the bond alternatives. So, when you're thinking about income, don't just think about it in a vacuum. It does have an impact when you affect it with inflation and taxes.